I'm Rocky De La Fuente, and I want to be your next United States Senator for the great state of Rhode Island.
Rocky De La Fuente is a millionaire businessman.
Bueno, acá me lo por este Vermont, and I'm running for United States Senator in Delaware.
De La Fuente has run for the Republican nomination for Senate in 9 states overall, including here in Florida. He lives in California, so obviously he ran there. He likes to vacation in Wyoming. Hawaii, Minnesota, and Washington made it easy to get on the ballot. And Delaware, Vermont, and Rhode Island are all small, so in theory, easier to win. But after 6 months of campaigning, he's lost every one, except Rhode Island, which votes tomorrow. He'll probably lose there too.
Pásenle, 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 pásenle. Colóquense, les explico los números en lo que estamos tratando de...
This is totally legal. The Constitution only requires that senators, quote, when elected, be an inhabitant of that state for which he shall be chosen. So in most states, it only takes a few hundred signatures and some cash. In some states, aside from the signatures, it's free. De La Fuente made his millions in everything from banking to car sales to real estate. So money's no object.
No vamos a ganar la elección. La elección no le echamos la gana para ganarla.
Why are you running for Senate in 9 states?
The job is the same job. Either if you do it for Washington State, or you do it for Florida, or you do it for New York, or you do it for Vermont.
Every state doesn't have the same issues, though.
Well, you need to understand for U.S. Senate, what can you do as a U.S. senator? And whatever the issue happens to be is how do you negotiate?
Soy Roque de la Fuente, soy candidato al Senado.
Corriendo en contra de Rick Scott.
Estoy corriendo como latino.
Rocky doesn't actually care what state he represents.
You have to do your civic duty.
I don't live here, I can't vote.
Where do you live?
New York.
Those where I'm running in New York?
In Florida, he even ends up campaigning for a state where he's not currently running, all just to raise his profile.
I'm running for Senate. I was able to qualify 9 states. Yeah, I don't expect to win any of the races. I just want to do it so people get to know me.
De La Fuente didn't really take the Florida primary seriously. He didn't spend much more than the $10,440 it took to register for the ballot.
Ahí estamos con las votaciones.
147,000.
So even though he fell short of his goal to win a quarter of a million votes,
mira, ya subió más, 163,000.
Oh, yes.
He still thinks it was a good investment.
Was 181,000 votes worth it? Was the Florida primary worth it?
The answer is yes, 5 cents each.
Yeah?
I mean, if you want to put a value to a business, I invested $10,440, did absolutely nothing, and I show you that I have a modium of support.
Yeah.
I'm going to get about over 200,000 votes, and that's basically less than 5 cents each.
Rhode Island seems like an even better investment than Florida.
Hola, ¿cómo estás? Rocky.
De La Fuente is spending $100,000 on this race.
My last stakes to run is Rhode Island, which I believe is where I have the best opportunity. I predict about 20,000 people to show up, and whoever can get 10,500 will win.
¿Dónde eres? Otro dominicano aquí nos están invadiendo poco a poco.
It's the week before the primary, and this is only his third time visiting the state, ever.
¿Para presidente?
But De La Fuente is not daunted by a loss, or 9. In 2020, he'll run for something. He might even run for everything.
Will you run for Senate again in 2020?
If I'm already a senator, I will not be running for Senate. I will
Let's say you lose. Right. You're going to run for president or Senate in 2020.
It's all in the realms of possibilities.
Really?
Yes.
Any of it. All right.
As a matter of fact, you know what my goal would be if I decided to run for Senate? To qualify in the 33 states.
Why not just focus all your resources on a small state where you think you can win, like Rhode Island?
I did not know when I came up with this concept who was going to run in which state and which state was going to open the opportunities.
So at the end of the day, it's about keeping your options open to see where you can win.
You're not, yeah, I understand you're not married, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
That's correct.
So let me ask you a question. Are you keeping your options open?
Yeah, but marriage is a little bit different than representing a state in the U.S. Senate.
Well, I actually think marriage is more complicated.